Hi, I'm Vincenzo Coya, and welcome to Stat 545, the video series designed to help you write a clean and modern data analysis. So by now you're acquainted to the dplyr workflow. You're happily subsetting your data using the select and filter functions, as we went over in episode 4. But subsetting your data is only going to get you so far. You need to actually do some calculations before you do anything serious. So go grab your pair of pliers and let's start crunching some numbers with dplyr. So the first of four practices that we have for you today is to do computations on groups using the group by function. So do you remember the penguins dataset that we've been working with? It has data collected on three different species of penguin. Well, what if you wanted to subset your data to contain only the smallest penguins from each species? That's not something that the filter function can do very easily on its own. The task becomes much simpler with the help of the group by function. We first group the tibble by species, and then use the filter function to take penguins that match the minimum body mass. But what exactly is going on here? As usual with dplyr, the group by function takes in a tibble and outputs a tibble. On first glance, it looks like the group by function doesn't do anything. It outputs a tibble that looks the same as the input tibble. But behind the scenes, the tibble is now keeping track of which rows belong to which group. We can tell because when we print the tibble, it also prints out a group indicator. Once your tibble is grouped, dplyr knows to run its computations within each group, almost as if each group is its own tibble. The second practice is to create new columns using the mutate function. Say you wanted to calculate an overall bill size for a penguin by multiplying the bill length with the bill depth. Something like this is easy to do with the mutate function. Within the mutate function, start with the name you want to give the new column, and then do your calculation using existing columns. And there it is, our new column. But wait, why am I using a single equal sign this time and a double equal sign in the previous filter function? Well, in R, a single equal sign means that you're assigning whatever's on the right-hand side to a variable on the left-hand side. Whereas the double equal sign is actually doing a calculation. It's comparing the left and right-hand sides and gives us a value of true whenever an entry matches and false whenever an entry doesn't match. Here, let me show you. I'll calculate a new column of trues and falses depending on whether or not the penguin sex is male. Okay, how about this one? Calculate a new column of the median body mass for that row's species. Let's simplify things first by removing rows with missing values. Since we want to calculate the median for each species, let's first group the tibble by species. Now we can use mutate to make a new column containing the median body mass. Remember, because the tibble is grouped, the calculation that happens within the mutate function is happening separately for each group. And because the median only returns one single value, that single value is repeated for every row in the group. Let's do one more. Let's calculate whether or not a bill is big or small, depending on how it measures up to a predefined threshold. Let's choose our threshold to be 800 square millimeters. And let's store that value in a variable so that it's easier to change in the future. As usual, we'll use the mutate function to make our new column, and we'll calculate if a bill is big or small using the if-else function. It works like this. If the bill size is bigger than the threshold, then the calculation results in the word big, otherwise give us the word small. Notice that the threshold variable t isn't a column name of the tibble, but the bill size is. So why does this work? It's because dplyr first searches for a name in the tibble, and if it can't find the name there, it'll then check your workspace to see if you've made a variable of that name. The third practice is to reduce your tibble using the summarize function. Now, like the mutate function, the summarize function also calculates new columns, but the summarize function compresses a bunch of rows into one row. Last time, we used the mutate function to calculate the median body mass for each species. But what if we don't want the median to be repeated for each row? What if we only wanted to output the median once for each species? That's where the summarize function comes in handy, and its syntax is similar to the mutate function. And there it is, one value per species. But wait, where did the other columns go? Well, they're gone. After all, how could we squeeze all those entries from the other columns into a single row? Oh, and by the way, this tibble isn't grouped by species anymore. That's a default behavior of the summarize function, at least for now in the current version of dplyr. Because the summarize function reduces all the rows to a single row, it's most useful when used together with the group by function. Whereas, on the other hand, the mutate and the filter functions are both equally as useful with or without the group by function. Fourth is to calculate on many columns with the help of the across function. So we've calculated the median body mass for each species, both using the summarize and the mutate function. But what if you wanted to calculate the median everything? Let's go ahead and do that, this time also grouping by year. We have the tools to do this, but it's sure inconvenient to have to type out the calculation for each column. This is where it's useful to use the across function. Within across, first use the tidyselect function like where to specify the columns you want to calculate on. In this case, taking all numeric columns. And then in the second position, put the name of the function you'd like to run on those columns. And there it is. As usual, the summarize function reduced each group down to one row, and the across function helped calculate a median for all non-grouping columns. With these four practices, you're all set to do computations on your tibble that are reproducible, readable, and flexible. Keep these four practices in mind. Repeat computations on groups using the group by function. Calculate new columns using the mutate function. Reduce your tibble using the summarize function. And calculate on many columns with the help of the across function. I hope you enjoyed today's episode. Join us next class where we continue our discussion on ggplot2. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel so that you can stay up to date with more data analysis goodies.